Well, thank you for giving me the opportunity to present my work today. So as you mentioned, I'm Mathilde Ripart from UCL, and I'm going to present you a study about the morphological characterization and the detection of focal cortical dysplasia histopathologies. So as you already know, focal cortical dysplasia is an important cause of focal epilepsy, characterized by structural abnormalities that can cause focal seizures. And these abnormalities are classified into different subtypes in function of the histology and are known to have different impact on the likelihood of seizure freedom after surgery. Indeed, FCD2 is associated with better seizure outcome as compared to FCD1. And therefore, it is important to identify the histopathology prior to surgery. And to identify this lesion on MRI, previous studies have described association between FCD histopathologies and MRI identifiers on T1 weighted and flare contrast, such as the transmental sign, which is a flare hyperintensity present in the white matter for FCD2B only. However, these studies are often limited by a small cohort or focused only on one histopathology. And this is why today I'm going to present you a larger analysis on FCD1, 2A, 2B, and 3. And this analysis leverages a multicenter epilepsy lesion detection, also called MELD cohort, which is composed of more than 500 patients and 400 controls from 21 epileptic centers in the world. And for this analysis, we focused on 359 patients with confirmed histopathology, and we aim to highlight the MRI identifier that best differentiate FCD histopathologies. So for that, we extracted surface-based morphological and intensity feature from T1 weighted and flare contrast, alongside with demographic information such as the age of onset. And for more information about the method behind this result, I invite you to have a look at my poster. So we highlighted features that were statistically different from each other in mean and variance using ANOVA and Levin tests. And as an example, we can see that FCD2 in light green and in red present a significant difference in cortical thickness compared to other FCDs, which are in blue and purple, and compared to controls in a bright green. Whereas there is no statistical difference in age of onset or epilepsy duration between these histopathologies. So we were also interested in the flare intensity at different cortical depths. And as you can see, all FCD present an hypointensity in the gray matter, compared to controls, but only FCD2B present a distinctive hyperintensity in the white matter reflecting the transmitter sign. Finally, FCD differ in their lesion location, with FCD2 being mainly located in the frontal, in the suprafrontal lobe, and FCD1 and 3 in the temporal pole. So to summarize, we highlighted with a red star feature that differentiates subtly differing histological abnormalities. And these features can be used to train a machine learning algorithm to classify subtypes. And indeed, these features enable us to differentiate FCD2 from FCD1 and 3 with 79% accuracy. And we can see that the model classified FCD2 with 83% sensitivity and FCD1 and 3 with 60% sensitivity, which is higher than the baseline model, meaning if we were randomly predicting groups based on the proportion. Finally, we also try to differentiate FCD2A from FCD2B, but only on the patient that have a flare image, as we showed that this contrast plays an important role on the differentiation of FCD2B. And we can see that FCD2A and FCD2B were classified with 65% accuracy. So to summarize, this large cohort of the MELD project enable to highlight important features that distinguish the histopathological FCD subtypes, but also to have a preliminary classification of these histologies, histopathologies. And this study is one among others. And for more information about the MELD project and how to join us, you can visit our website, or you can also visit my poster number 27 in room 1. And I'll be happy to answer your question there. Thank you.